Good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's service. Today, we are going to chant Juseige, followed by Jodo Shinshu Creed 1, and then Dharma Talks, both Dharma School and adults, and we are going to sing Ondokusan 2. So please, Shimin Gassho, please put your palms together. Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda. Gagon chose ga hishimu jodo shigan fumanzok seifu joshou ga gaomu ryokou fui dai seishut sai shobing seifu joshou ga Gashi jobut no, myosho chojippo, kukyo misho mon, seifu josho gak, ryok jin shounen, joe shubongyo, shigumu jodo, isho tengin shit, jinriki endai ko, Ushomu saido, shoujo sankumyo, kosai shuyakunan, kaihi chiegen, meshi konmoan, heisoku shouakudo, sudatzen shumon, kosojo manzok, iyouro jippo, Nichigatun shujuki, tenkou onpugen, ishu kaihouzo, kouseku dokuhou, jouodai shuchut, seppo shishikut, kuyou issaibut, kusoku shutokuhon, gamne shitnyouman, Tokui sangai yo, nyobut mugechit, sudat mi husho, gangaku erik, toshi saisho son, shigam nyakkokka, daisen no kando, kokusho tengin, Touchimyoke Namandabu 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 Namanda bu, gangi shiku doku, byodo sei sai, dou hotbo dai shin, ojo u, Namanda, 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 Namanda. Now we are going to read Jodo Shinshu Creed 1. Jodo Shinshu Creed 1. Entrusting the vow of the Buddha and reciting the sacred name. I shall proceed through the journey of life with strength and joy, revealing the light of the Buddha, reflecting upon my imperfect self. I shall strive to live a life of gratitude, following the teachings of the Buddha, discerning the right path. I shall spread the true Dharma, rejoicing in the compassion of the Buddha, respecting and aiding one another. I shall do my best to work towards the welfare of society. Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda. So it's been almost 2 months since the in-person instruction at the school started. My daughter Aoi enjoys school, and my son Hikaru is enjoying going to preschool twice a week, and he wants to go more. So that's a good thing. I don't think we are going to have a field trip for this school year, but maybe in the future. I'm sure that the school will plan a field trip to somewhere. And when I was in elementary school, we went to field trip. Actually, it was more like hiking. We went to a big park where over 150 kids can play. And it was different feelings to have lunch outside. And we were allowed to bring snacks worth of $2. In Japan, there is a snacks called dagashi. And they are really cheap. Mostly 10 cents, and some of them are 5 cents. And some kids were really good at buying snacks. You know, they spent $2 to buy a lot of snacks. And I liked one snack, which cost 50 cents. So I always purchased two of them. So I already spent $1 for two, you know, chocolate bar. And so, you know, I always have less snacks than my friends. But how many snacks you may have? If you spend $2 on snacks, the values of the snacks are the same. It's $2. You know, we all live different lives. We all have differences of genders, races, colors of skins, wealth, and titles. But the value of our lives are the same. It's not that someone is different from us, so they have less or more value. Everyone has the same value of life, as brilliant as shiny gold. Okay, so please be kind and gentle to everyone. Okay, so let's close Dharma School message with Gassho and Nembutsu. So please join me in Gassho, please put your palms together and recite Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu. And now I would like to share the words of Shinran Shogin from Notes on Essentials of Faith Alone. So please, Jamin Gassho, please put your palms together. Nehan oba metsudo という、無為という、安楽という、常楽という、実相という、発心という、発祥という、真如という、一如という、仏性という。仏性すなわち如来なり、この如来微塵世界に満ち満ちたまえり、すなわち一切群情界の真に満ちたまえるなり。草木国土ことごとく皆成仏すと説けりと。Nirvana has innumerable names. It is impossible to give them in detail. I will list only a few. Nirvana is called extinction of passions, the uncreated, peaceful happiness, eternal bliss, true reality, Dharma body, Dharma nature, suchness, oneness, and Buddha nature. Buddha nature is none other than Tathagata. This Tathagata pervades the countless worlds. It fills the hearts and minds of the ocean of all beings. Thus plants, trees, and land all attain Buddhahood. Namo Amida Butsu. ナモアミーダブツ、ナモアミーダブツ、ナマンダブツ、ナマンダブツ、ナマンダブツ。Good morning again, everyone. And I hope everyone is staying safe and well. And next week will be Halloween. And last year, there were not many trick-or-treaters because we didn't know much about the COVID yet. But I guess people got used to this life and how to social distance and wear masks. So I see many houses preparing for Halloween. And probably we see some trick-or-treaters. But 2 days before Halloween, October 29th, my son Hikaru will turn to 5 years old. Do you remember when we moved to Portland? He was only 8 months old. You know, he didn't know how to walk yet. Now he's going to preschool and he'll be kindergartner next year. You know, time flies, isn't it? And because my children are still small, I often think about what the future is going to be like. The climate is changing rapidly. You know, I heard Portland was really cool in summertime, but now we have at least a few days of over 104 degrees Fahrenheit or 40 degrees Celsius. Because it is dry in the summer, there are a lot of wildfires in the summer and smokes affect the air quality. This winter, or last winter, we had snowstorm and power outage. And this was the first snowstorm in, was it 30 or 40 years, right? And not only in Portland, but also in Japan, the heavy rain is becoming a big problem. There are floods in many cities every year. And some people might say that, well, everything is impermanent, so we have to live with it. But everything is impermanent means everything is constantly changing. So I believe there are two paths we can take: to let things change in bad way or change things in better way. Especially in regards to the climate change, there got to be something we can do about it. So I'm talking about this because I am in one of the committees of Jōrō Shinshū International Office. I forgot the official name of the committee, but something like relationship with another religion or something. And when we had first meeting with the committee members, Reverend Kuwahara said he would like to have some kind of event regarding SDGs with people of another religions. As you may know, SDG stands for Sustainable Development Goals, and there are 17 goals. The characters are kind of blah, so I'm not sure if you can read them, but if you are interested, you can type in Sustainable Development Goals or SDGs, and you will find a website regarding SDGs. And eventually, we would like to cover each one of them. And I am talking about number 13, climate actions right now. But this year at the event, we are going to have an event on the goal number 7, affordable and clean energy. And we will have Dr. Miriam Hinostra Rosa, who is the head of the Global Climate Action Unit in United Nations as a keynote speaker. And we will have a panelist from various faiths, such as Islam, Christianity, and Buddhism. And representing Buddhism, we have Reverend Don Castro, a retired minister of Rinban of BCA Seattle Betsin, and founder of Eko Sangha. And I'm sure that this will be an interesting event, so please sign up for the event if you are interested. The event will take place on October 30th. From 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. on Zoom, and I will be there too. You know, I'm interested in learning the balance between the ideal and the reality, what we can do for the better future, and how another faith think about this issue. And, you know, since this is a Dharma talk, I was thinking about what the foundation of understanding regarding this topic as Jōrō Shinshū Buddhist. So the passage I shared at the beginning is from one of the writings by Shinran Shōmin titled Notes on Essentials of Faith Alone. Essentials of Faith Alone is written by Seikaku Hōin, one of the disciples of Hōnen Shōmin. And although there are differences of the understanding, Shinran Shōmin respected Seikaku Hōin, and he recommended his followers to read Essentials of Faith Alone. And this is one of the reasons Shinran Shōmin created the Notes on Essentials of Faith Alone for his followers to be able to understand the contents better. And these notes have mainly the two versions, Kōgen era version and Shoka era version. Actually, I should say Shinran Shōmin's own handwriting version and Shoka era version. And Shinran Shōmin's handwriting version is the period between 1256, 1257, maybe a little bit before. And Shoka era is 1257, 1259. And there are slight differences in these two versions. And the word, thus plants, trees, and land all attain Buddhahood, was not in Kōgen version, which predates the Shoka version. So this means that Shinran Shōmin added these words after writing the Kōgen version, was Shinran Shōmin's own handwriting version. At Mount Hiei, Shinran Shōmin studied the Lotus Sutra and the Nirvana Sutra. And although Shinran Shōmin entered the Pure Land Way, it does not mean that he discarded all the understanding from these sutras. And Shinran Shōmin does not quote the Lotus Sutra directly in Kyōgyō Shinshō, but he quotes a lot of sections of the Nirvana Sutra in Kyōgyō Shinshō. And one of the main topics of discussion in the Nirvana Sutra is that all beings possessing the Buddha nature, and plants, trees, and lands possesses the Buddha nature too. And thinking about the reason Shinran Shōmin added this word, thus plants, trees, and land all attain Buddhahood in his Notes on Essentials of Faith Alone, it is difficult to understand his intent, but I assume that he wanted to clarify that all beings possessing the Buddha nature doesn't only mean that all human beings possess the Buddha nature, but also every beings, including trees, plants, and lands, possess the Buddha nature. So through this word, I thought, with our self-centered mind of looking for more convenience in our daily lives, we are damaging the plants, trees, and lands which possess the Buddha nature. As we should respect each human beings as those who have same value of life, it is time for us to turn or change our mindset and respect the nature too. Especially after the Industrial Revolution in the 19th century, we human beings sought for more and more and destroyed the nature. But seeing all the climate change in recent years, it is time for us to rethink our self-centered mind. All plants, trees, and land all attain Buddhahood. So we have to respect nature, and we have to think about the way to live together with the nature. So what we can do? Well, what each individual can do might be small thing, but the accumulation of the tiny, small things become big when we do it together. So saving the energy could be one of them. Recycle, using own utensils when going out to eat rather than using disposals one. Using bikes or walk more. Use local stores. You know, there could be many things we can do for the future and nature. And actually, this is what I think. And I am sure everyone have different opinions. And I'm not forcing you to think as I think. But, you know, I just wanted to introduce my understanding regarding this matter. And I wanted to you to have interest in the event we are holding this Saturday. So I hope I see many people from our temple to join the event, and I hope we are able to learn something together. So today's Dharma talk was more like the advertisement of the event, but I hope it helped. And in closing, please join me in gassho. Please put your palms together. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda Butsu. And now we are going to sing Ondokusan 2. 1, 2, 3. Nyōrai dai hi no ondoku wa Miyoko ni shitemo hozu deshi Shishuchishiki no ondoku mo hone o kudakite mo shasubeshi. Ondokusan 2. The depth of gratitude I owe to Amida's great compassion, I will proclaim until my life disintegrates into dust. The depth of gratitude I owe to my Dharma teachers, I will express until my bodily form is finally shattered. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda Butsu. Namanda. So this concludes today's service, and I hope you will have a great day today. Today, we are going to have Dharma exchange led by myself. I will be talking about, actually, this is a lecture I gave for Los Angeles Betsuin, LA Betsuin, in September for their Ohigan service. I talked about one of the terms, perhaps even, in the primal vow. And one of the reasons I talked about it was, you know, LA Betsuin's kind of throughout theme of the year was the primal vow. So I thought, oh, maybe this is a topic I want to talk about. So if you are interested, please go to Oregon Buddhist Temple's website for the link for the Zoom Dharma exchange link. And if not, I will see you next week. So thank you for joining today's service. Thank you.
Thank you.